this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create this really cool kind of leaf roof inside of Revit. Actually, one of my students on my website has contacted me with a request how they can create something that looks like this. And well, we're doing that today. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours of content dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. This is basically the outline for this project, like a floor plan. I've already scaled the image in place and pinned it in place. If you want to learn more about images and how to use them in Revit properly, I have a whole dedicated video to that, and I'm just going to link that up in the cards above so you can check it out. Okay, now let us get started. So the first thing that I want to do is I want to add a bit more of these reference planes. So here you can see we have this vertical reference plane and this horizontal one. However, I want to have one for the center of each of these leaves and then also for the boundaries between them. So for that, we first need to figure out the angle, and the angle is basically 180 degrees divided by 8 parts, which gives us 22.5 degrees. So now I can simply go here to reference plane, and then I can draw a reference plane like this. Hit the escape key a couple of times. Let's extend it a bit more. And then here we can adjust the angle to be 22.5. Okay. However, it moved it a little bit, so let's actually move it in place here to the center intersection. Okay, just like that. Yeah, now it's in the correct place. Okay, so once we have the first one in place, then it's easy. So let's go here to rotate, click on copy, place the center of rotation in the center, and then we can rotate from here, just like that. Okay, then for the next one, we can select this one, and then we can simply mirror it with the pick axis option. MM is the shortcut. And now once we have these three, what we can do is we can simply select them. So hold the control key, select all three, and then go to mirror and mirror it around the main axis, just like this. And then for the ones below, I'm simply going to extend a couple of these that correspond to that proper angle, and this is what we get. Okay, so the next step is going to be to outline these, well, let's just call them leaves for now, and we're going to do that by using model lines. So I'm just going to click on model lines, LI is the shortcut, and then I'm just going to zoom in, start here from the center, and then let's go out following that reference line, perhaps up to here, hit escape. Then for this one, let's follow it up to there, hit escape. Then for the next one, up to here, just like that. Okay, and now I just want to mirror this one to the other side. So let's go to mirror and just mirror it to the other side. Now I'm not going to be doing these just because we can mirror the roofs just once they're finished. Okay, so moving forward, let's go back to model line. Let's now switch to arc. And then for the arc, let's go from here to the end point there. Okay, and then just repeat that here. Or I think I can actually mirror this. Let's see. Yeah, okay, that speeds it up a little bit. Let's go back to model line. And now I'm just going to switch this to arc. Click here. Let's go to this point around here. Create that arc. Then let's go down to this endpoint, finish that up just like that, hit the escape key once. And let's see, we have this one as well. So let's go from here to there, just like that. And now we can just mirror this one, just like that. And then for the rest of it, we can create a new arc. So let's go here to arc and go up to there. Let's see. Yeah, I think this would work. Okay, and we need the bottom one as well. So for the bottom one, let's go from here to the center for the first kind of part. just like that, and then to this endpoint. Yeah, kind of like that. Hit the escape key a couple of times, and now we just need to mirror, hold the control key, select these two and these two, and then we can just mirror those around just like that. So I think we should now have everything. So what we can do now is just select the image, and then I'm going to simply hide that element. Yeah, we have everything pretty much here. So I just need one more line. So this one, I just need to mirror that just like that. Perfect. Okay. So once we have all of this in place, now it's time to turn this into actual roofs. So let's go here to roof by footprint. Let's place it on, yeah, let's go with level one actually, hit yes. And then I'm just going to switch it to this smaller roof, and then let's use pick lines. Now first, make sure that define slope is checked on, and then click on the main two, and then you uncheck it, and then you do the rest. So just like this, and then you hit finish. Okay, so moving forward, again, roof, level one, hit okay or yes, pick lines, define slope, you pick the main two, and then you uncheck define slope for the rest of them. So we have the second one, let's do the others, level one, yes, pick lines, define slope, select the main two, uncheck, and then do the rest. Okay. And finally, we have just this one. So let's go again to roof, level one, pick lines, define slope, main two, uncheck, define slope, and then do the rest. Okay, so here I just need to use trim and extend to corner to fix it up, but that should be it. Perfect. And then I'm just going to select these two. So just hold the control key, and then let's just mirror those around. There we go. And if I go to the 3D view, let's see what this looks like. And as you can see, it looks really, really well. Now we might have to adjust the height. So this one might have to go a bit lower, this one as well. So you can just kind of play around with elevations. But overall, if I switch this to, let's go with realistic or something. Yeah, so when we add a little bit of shading, you can see that basically, we have a very interesting and complex roof created in Revit quite easily. So there we go. If you want to get access to this Revit project file or any of my other Revit project files, you can find that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above, and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.